My name is Miyu. I'm 25 years old. I work as an administrative clerk for a clothing company, and I'm a regular office employee. Another week finished without problems. In order to enjoy my long-awaited Friday, I was heading to the supermarket to buy some snacks. Fushiku, is that you?
Oh, Miyu, it's been like 3 million years.
No, I can't live for that long. This woman is my best friend, Fushiku. We've been friends since middle school, and even when we both became working adults living alone, our houses were close, and we would often run into each other like this. And for the record, Fushiku is her nickname, and her real name is Alyssa. Ever since we were kids, Fushiku lived in her own unique world, and because she was such a strange character, she was given the strange nickname, Fushiku. More importantly, are you in a rush?
How did you know?
Well, that's because you're stopped in a pose like the exit sign, so it was easy to guess.
I see. I have plans to meet up with Mr. Inukawa at 6 p.m. in the evening.
Mr. Inukawa? Wait, that's in 10 minutes. Sorry for stopping you.
I don't mind. Oh, I know. Let me introduce you to Mr. Inukawa.
What? But won't I be intruding?
That's not true at all. Mr. Inukawa should be happy too. Anyway, let's go.
What? Hey, wait.
What is it? Some snacks? Don't worry, I've already bought those.
Fushiku is seriously so strange. Is she a psychic? But what kind of person is this Mr. Inukawa? Where did you meet them?
In the morning, I had a very fateful meeting. Mr. Inukawa was staring at me. I was also drawn to him, so I got closer. And then we made a promise to meet at 6 p.m. tonight and run away.
Why does this feel like a period drama?
However, Mr. Inukawa has a situation, so he might not be able to come today.
Like working overtime?
No, because there's somebody that he is with.
Uh-huh. You mean he fell for you at first sight, and he's cheating? No matter what the situation, I don't think that's good.
But I am serious about this.
Wait, I don't really understand. But does that mean that you're in a hopeless romance?
I suppose you could say that. Perhaps it is all but a dream.
After we walked for a few minutes, we arrived to a location underneath the bridge near the riverbank. You're meeting up in a place like this?
Because this is where we met.
Wait, but this is the Inukawa River, isn't it?
That's right. It's because I don't know his name. But since it's Inukawa, I'm thinking about calling him a puppy. But I thought that might be rude when you first meet somebody. So I figured I could get permission later.
I have way too many questions about this. But, oh well. So where is Mr. Inukawa?
I'm looking for him right now.
As Fushiku said that, she was looking around the area, mainly near her feet.
Oh, Mr. Inukawa! I'm so glad we could meet. Meow.
What? A cat?
Yeah, it is. Did I not tell you this?
No, you didn't. I thought it was a human man.
I have no interest in human relationship. Mr. Inukawa, can I call you puppy from now on? Meow. Meow. Is that so? Thank you. You can just call me Fushiku. Meow.
Wait, are you having a conversation?
There are humans out there that are being called puppy, so why not?
No, well, whatever. So, what are you going to do with puppy?
About that. When I saw him this morning, I was thinking about taking him to the police station because puppy is well-groomed and clean, isn't he? He has a collar as well, so I thought maybe he was on a walk.
Well, he doesn't seem like a street cat, I guess.
That's why I came here one more time in the evening, and if he still seemed lost, then I should take him over to the police.
I see.
However, there is one big problem. I don't trust those guys. It brings back some old wounds.
What do you mean, old wounds? Why don't you trust the police?
If they're not able to find Puppy's owner, then Puppy will never come back to this earth again.
That's true. The police and other animal centers can only keep animals for a certain amount of time. So if they can't find the owner within a specified period, it turns into a sad situation.
However, my apartment building is only for humans. How about your place, Miyu?
I'm pretty sure pets were allowed. Do you want me to take them?
Really? I'll owe you one, Miyu. I know. To thank you, let me give you these snacks.
Yay. Wait. Catnip? This is for the cat.
Yeah, it is. And?
Fushiku wasn't a psychic or anything after all. Anyway, maybe we should start by taking him to the police for now.
Alright. I despise having to use their help, but we don't have a choice.
And so, Fushiku and I went to the police station, and we submitted the paperwork for Puppy.
Miyu, can you take me in your house today too? I was thinking about going to the vet first thing tomorrow morning.
Okay. We went to the pet shop to get the bare minimum materials and food for Puppy, and headed to my house. And we're home. Fushiku, hold on tight to Puppy so that we don't let him get away.
Sure.
I opened up my front door, and in order not to get caught on the red lasers, I snuck around to the back of the room, and I deactivated this trap.
As usual, you still love playing spy, don't you?
Actually, I've paired up in a team with a certain professor, and I work under the pseudonym Jack of All Trades. Miu to make unhappy people happy. But Fushiku just thinks that I like to play pretend that I'm a spy.
Seriously, you're such a strange one.
The next day, we took Puppy to the vet first thing in the morning. But there weren't any particular problems and he was healthy. According to the vet, because his coat of fur was clean and his health was also in great condition, it had to be somebody's pet cat. However, there were no cats like Puppy in the files of that vet. Fushiku and I managed to make a poster about the lost cat, so the vet in the nearby shopping street let us post them up. But all we could do was pray that the owner would show up as soon as possible.
Well then, I'll be back again soon, Puppy. I wish you the best. Meow!
Fushiku looked sad to leave as she headed back to her house. Puppy, I wonder what your real name is.
Meow! Meow!
I hope we can find your owner soon.
Meow! Meow!
But you do cry out a lot. Is this what they call crying at night? I took out my phone and looked up cats crying at night. I was right. They cry whenever they're sad or anxious or during the mating season. Don't worry, Puppy. I'm sure we'll find your parents. As I was playing with the cat toy with Puppy, my front doorbell rang. I wonder if it's Fushiku. I was terrified to check into the monitor screen. Crap, it's the landlord. She always reeks of perfume and it's always covered in brand name goods. I'm really not that fond of her. The landlord who lived in the room next door was a single woman around her 60s. She was living just off of collecting rent and she was always wearing brand name clothes and accessories on her. She's made fun of me for my clothes in the past too. Well, to put it simply, she loves to belittle people to make herself feel better. I was nervous as I reluctantly opened the front door. Good evening.
You bought a cat, didn't you?
What? Yes.
Why do you have a cat?
Why? Well, it's just that I'm taking care of it for just a short period and...
This place doesn't allow pets. You knew that, didn't you?
What? But pets are allowed, aren't they? That's what it says in the contract as well.
I have to write that. Otherwise, I can't get residence. In reality, they're not allowed.
You were trying to lure people in with pets?
Shut up! I already forgot about something I decided a long time ago. Anyway, starting tomorrow, our building does not allow pets.
What? But that's way too sudden.
Well then, you can get out right now.
Meow!
Oh, hey, Puppy, no, you can't come out here.
Meow! Meow!
It seemed that Puppy instantly hated the landlord as well. He was meowing at her as loud as he could.
The cat's name is Puppy. What kind of poor taste is that?
I can't say anything about that taste, but this person is the last person I want to hear it from.
Meow! Meow!
Ugh, it's so loud. Anyway, if it's loud again tomorrow, I won't accept it.
The landlord slammed the door shut and left. I'm sorry, Puppy. Puppy put his paws on my face and tried to cheer me up. That night, perhaps Puppy understood the situation, but he spent the night very quiet and calm. However, work was going to begin on the weekday, and I can't be with him all day. But when I thought about the landlord, I couldn't leave him at my house. Plus, I didn't know his crying at night would be this time, so I decided to have a pet hotel take care of Puppy for the next few days. I wonder if Puppy is okay. I felt better than leaving him at home by himself, but I couldn't shake off my concern that I couldn't really get around to all of my work. Over the last few days, he's had to live in so many different environments. That must really be stressful for Puppy too. I really hope we can find the owner soon, but... I contacted Fushiku, and we decided to meet at my house after work that day. In the event that we don't find Puppy's owner after this, we needed to talk about what to do. I ended up having to work a bit of overtime. I don't have any calls from Fushiku, so maybe she had to work overtime too? I sprinted home as fast as I could, but then, when I arrived, there was somebody standing there directly in front of my door. Fushiku... No, it's not you.
Shoot!
Excuse me, what are you doing?
No, nothing. That cat! I was thinking about taking him myself.
Excuse me, but also, why is my door unlocked? Did you?
Well, I am the landlord, so of course I have a key.
That's not what I'm saying. Even if you are the landlord, this is trespassing.
Because the cat was so loud, I thought I could come in here and try to train him.
Your ears, are they okay?
What?
The cat isn't there anymore.
Huh? But why not?
What do you mean, why? You're the one that said pets weren't allowed.
The situation has changed. If it's in my room, then it's okay. It's much bigger than your room, and I would be able to feed it some luxurious meals.
That doesn't make any sense.
You're so annoying. Anyway, you need to hand it over.
I refuse.
In that case, you need to move out today, and I'm going to change the keys tomorrow. If you don't want that, then you're going to hand over that cat.
How could you?
I already heard it all.
Fushiku, since when have you been there?
Since 120,000 years ago.
That's ancient.
Puppy is a wanted cat.
Which means?
I heard someone say in the next town over that they were looking for Puppy, and the owner is an extremely wealthy person that anybody in the town would know.
Really? But how did you know?
And that old lady is wanting Puppy because she wants the reward money. She probably thinks that she can get a really high amount for it.
What are you saying? That's not true at all. Well, if the owner was found, as a landlord, I would be happy to take responsibility and take him to that house. You two at work anyway, don't you?
I can easily take the day off.
See? Look at that. You want the money so bad that you would even take the day off of work.
I don't need it. If he's going to be happy and healthy with his owner, then that's more than enough.
Exactly. You can't put us in the same boat as you.
Anyway, the cat isn't in here right now.
I'm going to see for myself.
The landlord unlocked the door and went storming into my room.
Code Red, old lady, watch out!
The landlord fell right into the trap that I had set up, and a super strong, spiky floor appeared on the ground.
Oh!
Well, it's not going to kill you.
I feel like I'm watching an unathletic comedian.
Fushiku and I carried the now pale landlord outside. Fushiku and I both took the day off of work, and we headed towards the next town over.
Aren't you glad, Puppy? You got to see your owner!
Meow!
We had asked for their address in advance, and apparently the name of the owner was a man named Mr. Yamada. Wow, I've never seen a mansion this big and fancy before.
You're not just Puppy, you're Sir Puppy.
We rang the doorbell. A man who looked like a butler came out from inside of the house and ushered us in. After we went through many massive doorways, there was a man about 80 years old with white hair, who must be Mr. Yamada, sitting on a luxurious sofa.
Ah, Pup, I miss you so much.
Meow.
What? His name is really Pup?
Yeah, my baby is cuter than any animal in the world. That's why he's Pup.
Aww.
Hey, don't look so upset about the name.
How did you know?
It's written all over your face. It's still better than Inukawa, though.
In the end, it was Pup, so it's fine.
Both of you, thank you so much. Let me get you some tea.
Thank you very much.
I offer my thanks.
You said that you found Pup along the riverbank, right?
Yes, it was a fateful meeting.
But how did he get all the way to town over?
Oh, actually, anytime I leave the house, I'm always with Pup. You know how there's a very large park in the town over? That's where we went together. But then, I suddenly collapsed when we were there. At that time, it must have scared Pup, and then he ran away.
So that's what happened.
Luckily, I was saved, and I was fine. But I was so worried about Pup, I couldn't stand it. I'm truly so glad that we were able to meet like this.
I'm glad. You can't run away again like that, Puppy.
However, to tell you the truth, my body isn't going to stand much longer.
But I'm pretty sure 5'9 is the average height for a male.
That's not what he meant.
Anyway, this is only if it's okay with you two. But I was hoping you would take Pup and make him yours.
My apartment building is only for humans, and it will take too much time for me to move as well.
My place too. Wait, wasn't I kicked out already?
Kicked out?
Yes, well, actually. I proceeded to tell him honestly what happened over the last 2 days.
What a landlady! I can't believe she would treat animals like that! That's unforgivable! However, it seems that I've caused you some trouble, and I'm very sorry.
No, not at all. I had already given up on that woman and was planning on moving. But actually, I only recently moved into that building, so I was thinking about staying with a friend for a little while.
I don't mind.
Is that so? In that case, you should use this.
Mr. Yamada handed us a very thick brown envelope.
This is the reward money. Of course, I'm more grateful to you than I could express in numbers, and this isn't enough.
No, we can't accept this much.
But you need a house, don't you?
Yes, that's true, but this is...
Miyu, you must humbly accept, m'lady.
Why are you talking like that?
No, but when it comes to places that allow pets, it might make the rent jump a lot higher.
That's true. My current apartment was lying and saying that they allow pets. If I were to find a place that actually allows pets, it would increase my rent. And in that case, even if I could move, my expenses after that would become difficult.
All right. In that case, let me give you a house, too.
House?
Yeah, I actually have a house in the town over. It was my wife's art studio, but that wife is no longer here. We never had any children, so I was planning on putting it up for sale.
But you also have your butler as well.
About that, his child has a cat allergy, and that's why he can't take Pup. I beg you, will you please live together with Pup? It seems he already really likes you, too.
Meow! Puppy is also saying that that's what he wants. I once let him go already. To try to take him back just because we received a good offer goes against my path.
What path?
Is there any way? This is an old man's dying wish. I wouldn't be able to die in peace.
Please, this isn't an omen. All right, I would be happy to take Puppy in.
Is that so? Thank you, truly.
No, thank you.
I think I can write a good story now.
Fushiku, when did you become an author?
It all began on a beautiful autumn evening, the sunset glistening.
Stop right there, otherwise you'll go on forever. And so, not long after that, I'd be moving into a mansion and living with Puppy. Until then, Puppy would be staying with Mr. Yamada. The landlord was threatening to change the keys. They hadn't been changed out, and I was able to get in. Well, it would cost money to change the keys anyway. I need to hurry up and move soon. I should go and pay my respects to the neighbor.
Oh, well then, I have a good gift you can take.
My neighbor, who lived on the other side from the landlord, it was a married couple living there, and they were kind people who would worry about me as a woman living alone.
Why, hello there, Miu. What's the matter?
Oh, hello. Actually, I'm going to be moving out.
What? But you just moved in recently.
Actually.
100 ears are no match to one eye. Please, look at this.
A video?
That's right. It's from the other day when I was waiting for here for like 120,000 years. I was a suspicious person, so without saying anything, I was recording. And that was when you appeared, Miu.
Well, then you should have said something sooner.
No, it looked pretty interesting, so I was looking for the right timing.
What? This is the landlord, isn't it? Trespassing?
That's right. The night before as well, telling me that pets aren't allowed and yelling at me.
No, this is terrible. Oh, hey, ma'am.
The woman who happened to be walking by us was apparently another resident of the building. I still only knew my next-door neighbor's face, but that neighbor had been living there for many years, so she was good friends with everybody that lived in that building.
I always thought that the landlord was a strange person, but look at this.
This is pretty awful.
And she only looks at pets as money and nothing else.
Oh no, now I'm worried about my little Choco at home. Choco is a quiet girl, but I don't know when the landlord might complain about her. I'm going to move tomorrow if I can.
You're right. I'm going to do the same. Oh, miss. Miss.
My next door neighbor was catching the residents of the building left and right and kept telling everybody.
Looks like hallway chatter doesn't change, regardless of the generation.
Seriously, how old are you? A few days later, without saying anything to the landlord, I moved out. Of course, I had already told the building management company, so there were no problems. And now, I'm living a very happy life with Puppy. Oh, I wonder if it's Fushiku. When I looked at the screen, a woman appeared with battered hair and clothing. What? May I ask who you are?
It's all your fault! Because of you, all of the residents of the building disappeared! What are you going to do about it? I don't have any income!
This voice. Is that my ex-landlord? Well, that's none of my business. Why don't you sell your clothes or anything else you have?
I still have payments left on those!
Though, she was buying them with payment installations. Anyway, this has nothing to do with me, so I don't know what to tell you.
Oh, lady, you're in the way!
Oh, Fushiku, that person is my old landlord. Be careful.
Oh, it's fine. I brought Puppy with me.
Puppy?
Hey, it's you, isn't it? Why don't we have you join us at the station?
Hey, stop that. Let me go.
He's the puppy police. So he's a puppy for short, right?
Real puppy.
Meow. And with this, the tale of the puppy is finished. We'll be right back.